we kind of hit a wall and I decided to take a break. Oh, I should say later today we're also playing Bayonetta and some other stuff. Depends, though, how deeply involved I get to this game's plot. We played like 5 or 6 hours of this the other day, and we're only like a little over halfway through. So I guess I will start off with the last contradiction we saw, just to get kind of a warm-up. And we'll go through some of these here.
Oop. Didn't know Emma. Yet you bought her a freedom necklace.
I don't remember saying anything about buying Emma a necklace.
So you didn't buy her one? So you did buy her one. So that means you must have known her, and quite well, too.
Stop making such a big thing about this, Inspector. Look, I've been around a few years. The clock is ticking. And I admit I have an embarrassing weakness for attractive women. It was a stupid mistake. But that's all it was.
So you're saying you tried it on with her?
No, I didn't try it on. I bought her a necklace. I'm not aware that there's a law against buying presents unless, of course, the Third Reich has been elected while I was at a bridge party. Emma was old enough to make decisions for herself. And as a matter of fact, she decided that she didn't want to be bothered with an old fool like me, so...
Yeah, this guy is real fucking creepy.
Nobody got that.
So this guy is the rich father... of the dude who like kind of started Atlas in Third Eye. He's sort of involved with the stuff they do, but he's mostly kind of the money behind the stuff. His son Ryan is the guy who's more like directly connected to the sessions and does a lot of things like that. I guess we can go take a look at a Ryan contradiction that we last saw. Just to kind of so you guys can kind of get a feel from him.
So, you used to read a lot about voodoo and satanic rituals, but you don't know anything about devil worship?
Well, obviously. I just meant we don't worship the devil. We're not devil worshippers here at Atlas, Inspector. Ridiculous.
But the point is, Ryan, that you claim not to know anything about it, but admitted you were obsessed with it when you were younger. Are you sure none of that made its way onto the Atlas course? And that Lisa isn't basing her beliefs on anything within that course?
Lisa isn't basing her beliefs on anything other than her own imagination, Inspector. Look, we do use some techniques that some students find difficult, disturbing. We encourage them to see things differently, that's all. And some people simply aren't.
Guy's got a great fucking turkey neck.
Some people, like Lisa, that's why we introduced the aptitude test.
What's the aptitude test?
This. We ask students to fill in an aptitude test, medical history, psychological issues, that kind of thing, any medication that they have used in the past, any medication that they currently are using.
Hey, everybody.
Here, take a look.
Hey, Cost. Hey, Taco.
Basically, it's just to try and make sure that we don't get another Lisa.
Has it worked?
This is basically FMV so Phoenix, far. Right? Except if it's like just all of the investigation gameplay. So, as you can see, Paul and Ryan are kind of shady fuckers. There's other people in this town. There's Rebecca, Emma, James. And they're all kind of like connected in some way, shape, or form. The main gameplay element of this game is you have to try and catch people contradicting what they say. You can't use what other people said against them. You can only use what they said themselves against themselves, basically. And you use that by getting different items, and they'll say stuff about like what it means to them. And yeah, that's pretty much how it works. Noted events. So let's just go ahead and get back in here. We last left off. Let's talk to the chief. So the chief will kind of give us clues and stuff. And right now he was suggesting that the auto hypnosis bullshit is pretty kind of fucked up, and we have to kind of look into it a little bit. And so we've been, here, actually, I'll show you the inventory. So we've gotten a lot of inventory items now, and everybody has generally something unique to say about it. And so it's a lot to keep track of. And the last thing we got was the Atlas Aptitude Test. So the Chief kind of wants us to prove or contradict somehow that the auto-hypnosis shit isn't dangerous, because it clearly is, because somebody got kind of fucked up over it. Would it mean anything to you if I did this? Yeah, this game's fucking great. Alright, so we kind of went through a lot of the people yesterday. It was getting pretty late, so I was kind of getting my brain fried trying to talk to people. So we talked to this really crazy girl, Lisa, who believes that after she went through some of the stuff at Alice, she started seeing demons.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
So, claims auto-hypnosis not a major part of the course, students aren't coerced or bribed in any way, auto-hypnosis techniques are being phased out. Believes auto-hypnosis doesn't really work. So, also, once we find a contradiction, something they said would be, grayed out here. Maybe this has something to do with it. Yeah, this is the part where I kind of got stuck at. So any of you who were here yesterday and who kind of remember what we were doing, I would definitely appreciate some help. Don't like look up any guides or anything though. I don't want like just the answer. Like a nudge in the right direction would be helpful though. Okay, let's see. Well, at least the auto-hypnosis doesn't really work, though. Maybe something to do with Lisa. So, the doll was something with their doll burning ceremony or whatever, and like, getting rid of their self or whatever. Yeah, they carry it with a month. I have called the Chief, actually. I think the hints are like,
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
Stuff from the Chief, though. Emma was acting a little weird about it now that you mention it, but, oh, I can actually jump from the interiors. Okay. Yeah, the hints counts as a cheat. He used the black mirror but doesn't believe in auto-hypnosis. Did he say that? Let me, here. Hello, Frax. Welcome to the stream. Well, actually, yeah, let's just go back here. I just started a little bit ago, Frax. Also, hello everybody in the Vine chat.
Couple more questions, if that's okay?
So he says he still doesn't really believe in anything supernatural. I mean, auto-hypnosis is kind of supernatural. Used to read. Oh, I just said that because Vinny's still hosting me. There's a few people hanging out in there. So hello. Hello, hello. Alright, well. Maybe
on, if that's okay.
It's like between Paul, Emma, and Ryan that I feel like there may be something going on. I'm not, like, entirely sure, though. Because Emma's the one that's been, like, lying and contradicting herself the most.
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
Opposite of contradiction is cooperation. Oh, I guess that makes sense. Never tried auto-hypnosis herself. She never said the mirror. I mean, this is kind of a stretch. No. She says Kate used auto-hypnosis. So we know that the scrying mirror is also a form of auto-hypnosis, but that's what the one's conspiracy theorist dude said. And so she's not really contradicting anything she said herself. Mirrors don't work. No, I guess it's stress. Stretch, I should say. Yeah, this is like a detective murder mystery game, and it's full motion video too. So it's pretty fucking good. A lot of goofy ass expressions as well. There's also Satanists, yeah, that too. Yeah, like, I didn't expect the story to actually be really interesting. Damn, I got really sucked into it. There's a little bit of overacting in it. Yeah, we're kind of stuck at the moment right now. Let me hear.
Okay, that's it for now. Thank you.
Chief Wilson confessed that autonomous is in danger. Suggested looking into it further. Okay, well, I never did go back to Edenton Village here. And they said it opened at 8 when I originally came here, but they never really reopened. It's after 9, too. Alex, I gave you the one hint I know. Did you? I'm sorry. Something about satanic rituals you can press on, but I forgot the second. Oh, okay. I thought I already did that, but okay. Thank you for the tip. Do you know which person and cost?
ask you a couple more things, please?
The Atlas guy, okay. Drink man? Alright.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
When you say drink man, that's Ryan. Alright, let's go see what we can do with him. He's always... Just imagine, as soon as he hears you open the door from, like, the entrance to Atlas, he fucking starts pouring his drink. He's like, "Ah, Jinx is coming!"
Questions, if you don't mind.
Mirror. Still a black mirror himself. Let's read about magic. Kossi, if you're talking about proving how he doesn't know anything about, like, Satanism or whatever, we already did that. So that drink man was a generic version of Pepsi man. Yeah, totally. Yeah, see, we already doesn't know anything about devil worship. Has he tossed his drink? No, I don't think so. Hey, Jay Palmers, welcome to the stream. Paul said Lisa was disturbed by the techniques used on the course, but he mentions it is. Okay, Ice.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Well, we'll try that. Well, I think I would have made that connection, although we'll see if that's even a thing.
Ask about a few more things, please.
Yes, there's no truth in Lisa's accusations and no interest in the occult. Do with Liam. No. Oh yeah, we got information about that Monarch costume shop and we got like fucking mugged by somebody carrying one of those bags. So maybe the costume shop is a front for this cultist bullshit too. Blueberry.
So nobody has ever been affected by auto-hypnosis, except Lisa.
Hypnosis wasn't the problem, Inspector.
Lisa, I didn't really make that connection right away.
That's why we introduced the test.
But the hypnosis was the trigger, wasn't it?
Lisa arrived on the course believing we were all devil worshippers. She was nuts to start with. We didn't make her like that.
Well, as far as I can tell, Paul, you've had one student accuse you of devil worship and two others commit suicide. Some of your students aren't having a very good time on this course, are they?
Nonsense. Kate was enjoying every minute of it. She couldn't get enough of it.
Really?
She was full of the joys of life. Bubbly, confident, flirty.
With who?
You mean with whom?
With whom?
Pretty much everybody. Including me, as I remember.
Cost, it's really? Like the only mic'd up Jenks.
Did you respond?
I don't get into relationships with students, Inspector. Company policy. It's not professional.
Interesting admission. Oh, that Kate flirted with him. There's no way Paul would have turned down an opportunity like that.
Oh, wait, where'd that be under? avoid relationships with students, but just fucking said not too long ago. Where's that at? No. We're like all right on the fucking. He didn't buy it for Kate. Fuck. Well, I mean, he did say he didn't buy it for Kate. Oh no, Emma. Fuck. How do we connect this to Emma? Fuck. God, we are so close to, like, tying the thread together on the fucking Emma relationship, because we, like, know that Emma did that bullshit. I think Emma admitted to that, sort of. Where's that under? Oh, Emma had the relationship with Ryan. Okay. I once tried to date Emma. Right, thank you. Actually, I missed that.
Aha. So you avoid relationships with students, except for Emma, who you tried to date.
Oh, come on, Inspector. That was a long time ago.
And what about Kate Vine? Did you try to date her or not?
Oh, don't be so ridiculous, Inspector. Kate was an exceptionally clever girl. She knew exactly what she wanted, and she knew how to get it.
You mean that Kate approached you?
It wouldn't surprise me if she was playing everyone in the group. Kate had more enemies than you'd think. She was a very, very manipulative young woman.
10 p.m. Shit.
10 o'clock. It's getting late. I'm gonna have to pick up the pace if I'm gonna solve this by midnight.
I have to solve this by midnight? Fuck. Okay. I guess let's go talk to the chief? No, nothing yet. Alright, let's go see if we can talk to Lisa yet. She's back. No, doesn't appear to be back yet. Nope, didn't want to go there. Let's go take another stroll through the woods, I guess. Actually, let's talk to these fucks. Ooh, what's going on? How does he not notice he dropped that? Jesus Christ. Time to fucking do more petty theft.
Simon? Probably nothing important, but at this stage, I need all the clues I can get.
Something like a key dropping. Oh, here we go. Alright, what do we get? Business card was dropped by Simon. Aztec. Okay, I guess this is just JoJo's Bizarre Adventure now. Colts, Aztecs, you name it. Alright, let's do some woods investigation. If he's back home yet. Now is he just still fucking hanging out here? Alright, since there's new stuff. Is anything in the sex room going on? Anything in the orgy room? Nope. Okay. Oh, he must not be here. Okay. He actually fucked off and went home. They did say the cleaner comes at a weird time, so maybe 10? Oh, okay. Paul is the evil not Satan grandpa. Yeah. Alright, so we fucked off around the woods. Maybe somebody's actually in the restaurant now.
Tell him about Simon.
I really don't think it's my place, darling.
Oh my god. They're fucking around.
I just don't want to tell tales.
Tell him about Simon. You know what happened to him.
Oh!
So it's going to be that kind of evening, is it? Only if you deal.
Problems?
What?
Hello, Inspector. See you later.
Oh, does that mean we can actually go to the fucking haunted restaurant? Ooh, there's something here. Fucking steal their pills, okay. Take them, Jenks. Take them.
Isn't that interesting?
Damn it. Oh, I thought he was gonna fucking just take his pills and get really fucked up. Prescriptions made out to Rebecca were found in the cupboard. And they know anything about your pills?
Couple more questions, if that's okay.
Know anything about this?
Have you seen this before?
No.
Do you know anything about this?
No, sorry.
The cupboard downstairs, there's a lot of unopened stuff in it.
Is there?
Prescriptions. Made out to you.
Oh. They're just spare painkillers.
Yeah.
The chemist always gives us too many, he's a friend.
Spare painkillers. Who just gets spare painkillers? Prescription grade, as a matter of fact. Chemist gives them too many. Chemist is a friend of the family. Okay.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
I guess we can't harass Ryan. Maybe he's back at the house. Didn't they say Kate had, like, a trace amount of painkillers in her body or something? Oh, that's right. She did say she was pure. Thank you, Cooking. I actually just forgot about that until you mentioned it.
A few more questions, please.
Oh god, where the fuck was that? That was like, oh yeah, under the drugs. Hey Pam, how's it going?
So, you don't take any medicines except for prescription painkillers.
Well, they're not actually for me, they're Ryan's. For some reason the chemist always makes them out to my name. He's an old gentleman.
Does Ryan need prescription painkillers?
Yes, he's got arthritis.
Really? He's young to suffer from that, isn't he?
He doesn't have it badly, but he does need medication from time to time.
What medicine is it?
I couldn't tell you, to be honest. Ryan will know.
I don't know what
so
drugs my husband
the
gets.
One using the prescriptions. I think I might have a word with him, work out exactly what this medicine is. Be back later on, if that's okay.
Oh, you're good now. That's good to hear, Pam. To answer your question, Dazar, I'd love to join. Just, you know, it's up to Vinny to make that decision. Alright, let's ask everybody in town about prescription painkillers, I guess. Actually, the fucking druggie who's growing the legal drugs may know more.
Ask you a couple more things, please.
It's unlikely that you would know. Okay.
Recognize this at all?
Yeah, he fixed my laptop.
Does he live locally?
I think so.
Thanks!
Seen this before?
Don't think so.
This guy is always like smiling and just looking off screen. It's really weird.
Probably be back later.
He never fucking looks Jenks in the eyes. This game is called Contradiction, Spot the Liar. You were out just from yesterday. Okay, gotcha. I like you, Dazar. Always appreciate the kind words. Why is his audio a bit fucked up? He's always fucked up, dude. He's always so stoned. Yeah, that could be why. Let's go talk to the old creeps.
A few more questions, if you don't mind. Do you know who this is? Dean Hayfield, Aztec.
Sorry, never heard of him. We have some prisoner of a sort.
What?
Does R.I.T. Large guy. No manners.
For you.
Seen this before anywhere?
No.
No.
When did Ryan begin to suffer from arthritis?
Ryan doesn't suffer from arthritis.
Really?
The only thing that Ryan suffers from is a pathetic inability to deal with any kind of discomfort. He pulled his back sometime last year. Since then, he's going around telling everybody he suffers from arthritis.
I thought he had medication for it.
Oh, he only has medication because his GP, who is almost as dysfunctional as he is, keeps prescribing it for him.
So you don't believe he really has arthritis?
Not at all.
He's prescribing him medication. Well, shit, that's something.
That's it for the time being, thank you.
Wonder. Oh, nope, I don't want to go back in.
A few
nope.
more questions, if you don't mind. Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Probably be back later.
I actually wanted to go behind their garage. Ooh, something new. Oh. Nothing new, actually. Okay. Can I open up the garage door again? Damn. The cinematic just looks slightly new. Okay. Look behind the pub again. Yeah, I like how his fucking license plate just says random. Just for consistency's sake. Just double checking the shed. Alright, let's ask Simon about the shit we just stole from him, if the game will even let us.
Couple more questions.
Sorry, you gonna try to go to bed? I gotta ask you some dumb shit.
I think you dropped this outside. Someone you know.
Oh, this is just from some IT guy I met. I don't need it.
Enough. I noticed some numbers on the back. Do you need these?
I don't know. What is it?
1905?
Oh, yeah, that's just a pin or something. It's okay, I can remember it.
So, not an offshore savings account or anything?
No, it's not important.
It's not important. All right, Benedict Cumberbatch, what do you say?
Did you know about Ryan's arthritis?
Ryan? He's got arthritis?
Apparently.
No, I didn't know. I hadn't noticed he had any problems.
I don't want to ask him about this yet. I don't want him to take it.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
Ask Emma.
Have you seen this before?
Nope. Sorry, never heard of him.
And what do you know about this?
Oh. This is Simon's. I bought this for him when we were on holiday. Has he lost it?
He dropped it.
He can't keep anything.
Just give it back to you.
Did you know about Ryan Round's arthritis?
Arthritis? I didn't think Ryan had arthritis.
It's not kombucha, but it's like a Chinese knockoff kombucha, basically. God, why do people upload things to TinyPick?
Be back later on, if that's okay. Is this yours?
Yeah. That's for my keys. Where did you find it?
Just outside.
Right. Oh, it must have come off when Nathan dropped my keys off. He was borrowing my car.
That's very trusting.
Yes, it is. I am a bit too trusting, really. It's a new car as well.
He said, like, a way fucking long time ago.
Aha. So the bike's the only way you can get to work, yes?
Yeah.
What's wrong with the car?
I can't drive the car yet, can I? I don't have my license.
Right.
I got a windfall from an insurance payout. Just figured I'd buy something sensible with it straight away instead of wasting the money.
What was the insurance payout?
It was for a laptop. It got stolen down at Atlas.
At Atlas?
Well, they didn't break in. I think they just walked in and took it. The laptop was in a storeroom, but I think the lock was broken, to be honest.
Doesn't sound like they're taking their security very seriously.
Actually, it got a lot better after that.
I think I'll check it anyway.
Must have been a very nice laptop to be able to buy a car with the insurance.
Yeah, fuck's sake.
Or a very cheap car. Might have to have a talk with Ryan about his security measures.
How fucking, like, either it was insured to hell and back, but...
Thank you.
God damn. What a fucking laptop. Oh, I'm sorry, he probably bought a Razer fucking 4K laptop. Where the fuck is Ryan? Oh, here he is. It does sound like insurance fraud, yeah.
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
Let's give him about all this bullshit.
Know anything about this?
No, I don't. I'm sorry. We have our own IT chap. Lovely chap, in fact. Fat and sweaty, though. It's like a double act, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Have you seen this before?
No, sorry.
Do you know what the medicine in the cupboard at the pub is for?
You'd better ask Rebecca about that. I'm not exactly sure what's in there. She tends to keep her wares under lock and key. Do you know, our wedding night was quite a surprise.
Tell me about your arthritis.
Oh, you found out about that. Well, yes, I'm old before my time.
It's very unlucky to have it so young.
Well, I take a lot from life, Inspector. And sometimes life likes to give you a little bit back. I mean, it's not too bad, it's not too debilitating. It's mainly some in my right hand, some in my left hand. It's not particularly a problem. Makes it difficult to hold small things, though.
What do you take?
Like my
for
penis.
It?
I get a prescription painkiller.
How often do you need that?
Not often, as and when. I keep some here, I keep some at home. It's not a problem.
Arthritis is not a problem. Nah, we don't really know.
Were you at Atlas when Simon's laptop was stolen?
Oh, I believe I was, yes. It was taken from the storeroom in the hallway.
Was it ever recovered?
No, we didn't catch anyone. We're quite exposed out here. Somebody could just wandered along the lane, seen into the storeroom. It's not particularly secure. They could have been in and out within minutes. That's why we advise people to keep their valuables with them. You can't be too careful these days, Inspector.
You can never be too careful. Can we go check out the storeroom? I hope. I'd love to check it out. I guess not. At least not yet, anyway. Wait, I'm sure he said something about security before.
Ask you a couple more things, please.
Wait, hold on. Advise the students and then they do the stealing bit. Where's that at? The TV was a DVD thing. Yeah, and Bean, this is a modern live action FMV game. Fuck. Okay, so Simon's laptop was stolen, laptop taken from a storeroom. The students keep their valuables with them. Oh, this was back with Liam. So I think it would have anything to do with that. Oh, good point, Henny. I am enjoying the game so far. Totally forgot about that whole drug bit. I would have probably come around to that soon. No, really? Oh, it doesn't keep any medicines on site. Okay.
Aha. So, you don't keep any medicines on site at Atlas?
No.
Except your prescription painkillers.
Well, these are not available to the students.
But they are kept on site.
Yes, but they're locked away. They're kept in the storeroom. Nobody would have that.
You're sure about that?
But you just said the storeroom is, like, fucking easy to get in.
Painkillers, Ryan?
Painkillers. Just painkillers. Normal painkillers.
Paracetamol.
Painkillers, man.
Codeine. Morphine.
Well, all right, they're morphine tablets, yes.
Oh,
holy shit.
Really?
Oh, come on, Inspector. I know what you're thinking, but there's no way Kate could have had access to them.
Because they're in the storeroom.
Well, not just that. She wouldn't have even known about them, or where they were.
Sure about that?
Yes.
Fucking morphine tablets?
So it is morphine Ryan's taking. The pieces are starting to come together. Now I just have to work out how Kate got hold of it. If it was Ryan's morphine she got hold of course.
So the storeroom isn't particularly secure, yet you keep your morphine tablets in there. I thought you said no one could get access to the morphine, but they could quite easily, couldn't they, Ryan?
I didn't mean that storeroom. I meant a different storeroom. I keep them in there.
Okay. So where was it locked up?
It's upstairs. It's got a combination lock on it. Nobody could have access to it except me and Dad.
Oh, combination lock, you say?
Don't mind. Have a look at that, if you don't mind.
Don't mind at all.
Thank you for the follow,
NB. Combination locked room, I see. Well, I might have a look around for that. See how secure and combination locked it really is. Thank you. Probably be back later.
Hey, finally get to go upstairs. I've been waiting for this. Is there an archive channel for GPM streams? Yes. If you look at the bottom of my Twitch page, you can find a link to my quote unquote video vault. I have fallen behind, unfortunately, because it's kind of a pain in the ass to cut all those videos together by myself. So I think I may just start uploading the full uncut streams on there. Just to kind of get push more shit on there. But yeah, okay, so let's thank you, Buddha. Just can we use this? Yeah.
Welcome. If you would like to.
What?
This exercise is all about identifying the difference between the image one presents to the world and one's real self, which lies deep in our unconscious. As you move through the network of mirrors, practice seeing yourself as a stranger. The more you separate from your persona, the more aware you will become of your true desires and ambitions. Chant with us. I am free from my image. I am free from my past. I am free from myself.
Holy shit.
I am free from my image. I am free from my past. I am free from myself. I am free from my image. I am free from my past. I am free from myself.
This exercise involves the use of liberation masks. You have now completed Module 1. Module 2 covers boundary testing, threshold testing, and extreme testing. Please read the notes carefully before attempting the module.
What did we get? Combination. Let's ask him about the fucking mirror room. Hey, Ryan, so about that room.
Can you tell me what you know about the mirror room upstairs?
Oh, you found that then. Well, it's very similar to the costumes, Inspector. It's designed to help the students look at themselves differently.
And what do you do with the mirrors?
You look at yourself, Inspector. You look at yourself. Until you start seeing yourself as others do. And you don't see yourself as
Ryan,
as you do
what
anymore.
The fuck, man?
It really, the idea is that you can see yourself eventually, any way you wish.
So why in a locked room?
To make sure you're not distracted, that's all.
How often is it used?
Not often, a few times a month. Some students find it useful, some don't.
Did they say something about mirrors? Like, they don't use them anymore? Or something like that? That's a really, really good screen cap, Bagel. I think... Here, let me... This face summarizes how I feel about this game. Only for the occasional sacrifices. No biggie. Yeah, that guy is taking morphine tablets. He's just fucking chugging scotch all goddamn day. God, is there something else about mirrors? Is it being phased out? Isn't that technically an auto-hypnosis? Someone draw Buff Jenks throwing the devil horns. God, that'd be a wonderful picture to see. So we know the scrying is it's a form of auto-hypnosis, because Creepy Dude told us that, but he never, Ryan never told us that, so we can't use that against him. I don't think we can actually get into the storeroom. We just went into the mirror room. You would think it would be worthwhile checking out the storeroom, though.
That's all right. For the moment. Thank you.
Let me go ask Paul about the mirror room, see what he has to say. Ryan says he doesn't believe in scrying, but he never said that the mirror stuff was a form of scrying, so we can't use that against him. Let's go ask Paul. He would, have something to say about the fucking
ask
mirror room.
Ask about a few more things, please.
Ask about his laptop.
And what do you know about Simon's laptop being stolen from Atlas?
No, I wasn't happy about it.
What did you do about it?
Ryan paid a con man to install a complicated CCTV system at twice the price that it would probably have cost. Seemed to do the trick, though. We haven't had a theft since.
Good evening, DSC. Not happy about theft, and since it's all CCTV, no theft have happened since. Okay.
Can you tell me about the room with the mirrors at Atlas? The one with the combination lock.
How did you get in there?
I was given the code for the combination.
By Ryan?
Well, nobody else is allowed to know the code, are they?
Not in theory.
So how's the room used on the course, then?
It's a meditation room where the students can reflect on themselves. That helps too. It's part of the program.
So you send the students into the room, they put the CD on, they stare into the mirrors. And how long does this last for?
Until the CD finishes or they fall asleep. What else would you like to know?
Am I gonna upload this? Yeah, I'll probably make some, highlight bots of it, and then I'll put it on my channel. Yeah, you know, I guess I could do that. I can just make the highlights in Twitch, and then upload them from there, rather than... Oh, God, let's see. Let me ask
later on, if that's okay.
Well, we got the code from James. A lot of names in this fucking game, so let's go ask... Yeah, let's go ask Simon about it. Since he was the one who had the code.
Couple more questions, if that's okay. Do you know about the mirror room at Atlas?
Yeah.
What's it used for?
But it's mainly for the auto-hypnosis module. You go in, and you stare into the mirror, and you go into a trance. Then, when you're ready, you come back out.
So you just go in whenever you want to?
No, there's certain times when you're allowed in, and only they know the combinations anyway, so you can't really get in.
But you don't know the combination?
No.
That's just... Yeah, sure, bud. Oh, whoops. Here we go.
Aha. So you didn't know the combination to the locked mirror room?
Nope.
Except... you'd written it down, hadn't you? This is the combination to the mirror room, Simon, that you wrote. It isn't a pin. It's a combination.
Yeah.
You see... this sort of thing makes me suspicious, Simon. What were you doing in there that you didn't want anyone, including me,
find out.
Yeah.
It's just part of the course, isn't it? I just wanted to go in there when I was ready.
On your own? Didn't give the number to anyone else?
No.
Simon, there was morphine kept in that room that might have played a part in Kate Vine's death. Did Kate have the number?
Yes, okay.
Fuck.
We both went in.
Together?
We were trying to outdo each other. We both tried to morphine.
What do you mean trying to outdo each other?
What? It's part of the course. To see how far you can push yourself. To see if you could do something you wouldn't normally do.
When was this?
A few months ago.
How often did you try it?
Only that once. I'd never do it again.
How about Kate?
I don't know. Sorry.
One hour.
So that's how Kate got the morphine. But what exactly does this testing involve?
Could this have been
what killed Kate? 11 o'clock. Mm. Just an hour left to solve this thing.
Are we actually like that close to being- Wow, okay. I think we're gonna fucking beat the game tonight. Oh, I'm gonna miss this game when we're done with it though. Here's your pot. There's no, it's not an actual time limit. It's just, as you do key story events, the clock goes up.
A few more questions, please.
Hey, Vape God. Vape God, can we ask you about the shit you just did, Vape God?
Thank you.
No, I guess
probably
not.
Probably be back later.
Maybe it was some new herbs, quote unquote. Let's go check out his greenhouses. New dank. Yeah, they just straight up put a filter. I mean, I guess that makes sense. Because they didn't want to reshoot all these scenes. Oh, hey, there is something new. What?
So James is interested in poppy pods, is he?
Poppy.
He's got some explaining to do.
Ha. Ha ha. You know, if you eat enough, you can see, you can get really fucked up. But you need to, like, just a lot of poppy. Alright, good night, Cost. Thanks for coming to the stream.
I'll ask you a couple more things, please.
Yo, those opiates.
What can you tell me about several boxes of dried poppy pods in the greenhouse back there?
Feel free to take some if you want.
What are they for, James?
Decoration? Why?
Decoration.
There's a big market for them among the over 70s.
So what are you doing with them?
Selling them? To grannies?
Okay, James, let's just cut to the chase. Are you extracting opium from them?
Me? I can honestly say I've never done anything like that, Inspector.
Sure about that?
Scout's honour.
And who was the guy delivering them?
A friend. Someone gave them to him. He asked me if I wanted them. I said I'd have a look and see if I liked them.
You just thought you'd have a look? No particular reason?
I'm a plant scientist, that's what I do.
Have you ever sold them to anyone else?
I only got them a few minutes ago.
In the past. You know Kate's body had opium in the blood when it was found?
No, I didn't. Hey, that's nothing to do with me.
Let's hope not.
Obviously it's used for decoration, sure, bud. See, never extracted opium from pods from a friend who didn't want them.
That's it for the time being. Thank you.
I wonder if you can go talk to Crazy Girl again. Alright, it's like 11 o'clock. No, still can't talk to her. Wonder where she fucked off to. Let's call the chief. Nope, nothing. Okay. Alright, let's go down the list, I guess, since we got some.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Anything about
poppy pods? What do you know about poppy pods?
Poppy pod?
Ever come across anyone selling them, using them?
No.
I swear that's the same no
Thank
clip
you.
Every
Probably
time.
Back
it was just like, they did one cut and it was like, alright, this is perfect. We'll just use this one, like, for the rest of the game. anything behind the house? Anybody jerking off? Nope. They move around sometimes, Guy Tom. Anybody in the Phantom restaurant? I mean, it's 11. You can be, oh no. You know, it sounds like there's a lot of patrons. There's absolutely nobody here.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Do you know anything about a locked room at Atlas with mirrors in it?
Not off the top of my head, no. I think that's a question for Ryan.
What do you know about poppy pods?
Go on.
Ever come across anyone trying to sell them or anything like that? Maybe even in here?
Not that I know.
Doesn't know much about poppy pods, but did you know? The chemist would know. you would know poppy seeds. You can make opium.
That's all for the moment.
Okay, guess not. Damn. Clearly, the person doing that behind the pub, just in case. Just in case. Did she? She grew plants. She knew. Oh, she did. Okay. Interesting. Thank you for pointing that out.
A couple more questions, if that's okay.
Used to grow, Salvia. No. You wouldn't know. Just because she used to grow salvia doesn't mean that she would know what.
Be back later on if that's okay.
She knows, probably knows what it is. Puppy guy probably bailed, yeah. Can we go to the Edenton village yet? No, of course not. I bet you that's where the final boss of the game is gonna be. Something stupid. Hey, I know you guys are trying to sleep, but...
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
Odd question, but have you ever seen anyone handling dried poppy pods?
Poppy pods? As in, for opium? No. Though, James did have opium tea once, I think.
Where did he get it from?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't ask. James does his own thing.
What does opium tea taste like?
I don't know. I didn't try it.
Really?
I didn't want to risk it, did I? But I went to hospital once. I had codeine, and I went into anaphylactic shock. The doctor said it was an opium derivative, apparently, so...
But you just...
Aha. You and Kate took morphine in the mirror room. That's what you said, isn't it?
Yeah.
But you're allergic to opiates, Simon. Opium. You didn't take the morphine at all, did you?
Well, no, I didn't.
Ooh.
And Kate did.
I thought you were trying to outdo each other. That was the point, wasn't it?
We weren't trying to outdo each other as such.
Go on.
Ryan wanted me to test Kate. To see how far she would go to be prime candidate. Prime candidate. It means the best person in the group, basically.
What do you mean test her?
But you do it in pairs. One person's the tester, it's me. And the other person's the...
victim.
Well, it's not like that. It's completely consensual. It's just boundary testing. Ryan wanted me to test Kate.
Because they thought she was the best student.
Well, maybe. I don't know. I just did what I was told, okay?
Except you decided to give her morphine. To break the law.
Well, I can't change that now, can I? She didn't die of a morphine overdose, did she?
She died because she drowned. But she drowned for reasons that aren't clear.
Atlas seemed to have this all neatly worked out.
Mm.
If Simon's telling the truth, Atlas are lighting the fuse and then retiring to a safe distance, letting students test themselves and push themselves to their limits while avoiding all comeback. Is this what happened to Kate?
Oh, I really wanted it to be actual demons. God damn it.
Thank you.
Everybody just got really fucked up on drugs and their brain got fried.
Let's ask you a couple more things, please.
Talk to Emma, if she knows anything. Ask her about this stuff.
Did you know about Simon's laptop being stolen?
Yeah, because it had all my college work on it, which I hadn't backed up or saved. Not that it mattered much, but I did buy a new one. And Simon uses it now, when I let him.
Do you know about the mirror room at Atlas?
Mirror room? No, I heard about it, but I think it was only for the students later on in the course. Something like that.
Know anything about poppy pods? Do you like to get fucked up?
Have you ever known of anyone selling dried poppy pods?
Poppy pods? Don't think so. Isn't that opium?
Kind of. It's okay. Do you know what a prime candidate is at Atlas?
Yes, it's what every student wants to be. It's the best student. Apparently you get a great high-paid job afterwards. I don't think that really happens, though.
Did you know anyone in the running to be prime candidate?
What, like Simon? I don't think they picked Simon, to be honest.
Mm.
Well, he's got too many morals, and you can't have both at Atlas.
His morals are incompatible. Okay.
Thank you.
Interesting.
Probably be back later.
Oh, do you think Simon did it? Because... Oh, do you think Simon was jealous that maybe... Kate was going to be the prime candidate, so he, like, fucked her up really hard. Oh, God, what the fuck? There's a lot of... I don't actually know who the murderer could be. Like, there's a lot of good candidates. I mean, it's probably somebody, you know, Atlas-related. Let's go check the lakes. Did I already check the lakes? I don't remember. No, I actually didn't yet. Do our daily look through the woods here. Oh hey, something new, wow.
Just keep pushing.
Oh shit.
Just keep pushing. Keep
pushing. What?
Keep pushing. You can push it all the way in, Tom, if you want to.
What the fuck?
Excellent, Tom.
Excuse me. Would someone care to tell me exactly what's going on here?
Don't come any closer.
That man needs a doctor.
No, he doesn't.
I don't need a doctor. I'm fine. Go away.
What is this?
A test.
Of what?
What does it look like? It's a threshold test. A pain threshold test. I thought, you were supposed to be good at working things out. Inspector Jenks.
And so this would be for Atlas, would it? Kyle?
You disappear now!
It's not a good idea to talk to a police inspector like that.
Do you want me to make you?
It's okay, Tom. Mr. Jenks won't be bothering us anymore.
Don't make any rash commitments.
Oh, hey, you're just gonna steal your keys. Don't mind if I do.
Well, well. You really should take more care of your things, Ryan. Is your keys, Kyle?
Oh, no. Damn it. Hoping he would just steal them.
So that's threshold testing, is it? Sticking a skewer through your hand?
Oh, did I take one of his keys, though?
I could just ask Ryan or Paul directly about this, but I think I'll bide my time. See what I can do with this key fob first.
He took his key fob. How would he not know? Oh, look at that later, Radical. I wonder where we could use that at. I can't think of any, like, cars nearby.
Just a few more questions, if you don't mind. Know anything about poppy pods? Come across anyone selling them or anything?
Poppy pods? Well, don't tell anyone, Inspector, but I hear that you can make opium out of those. Why do you ask?
Doesn't matter. Now, tell me what a prime candidate is.
You're learning a lot, aren't you, Inspector? Prime candidates are simply the best students, the ones with the most potential.
And what benefits do they get from that?
Well, they get the top job.
Which is?
Well, we have a deal with various multinationals. We train students to be exceptional, truly exceptional. And they get a wonderful top job. It seems very
top
simple.
Top job?
And how do you decide
top
who
dog.
The prime Bart candidate Bart. Is?
Do you test students?
No.
Did you ever, say, ask Simon to test Kate, for instance?
Oh, you've actually been speaking to Simon, haven't you? I really wouldn't trust anything that Simon Thompson says. You know, he spent the best part of 2 months trying to undermine Kate. No. Simon Thompson, it really isn't my place to speculate, but if you're looking for motives, Inspector, he certainly had a few motives. More than I.
A motive to kill her, do you mean?
Now that's very interesting, Inspector. Well, that's up to you to decide.
Simon had been trying to undermine me, so that's what I was thinking, although... Don't really like to test... Don't really want to believe this guy. He keeps lying about morphine and drinking, and students aren't tested, but... Wait. I thought he said some of this... No, that's different, yeah. Okay,
thank
I guess
you.
Let's
Probably
go...
be back later.
Let's go see if that... car fob has anything to do with the car. Actually, what's his face did say he had a car now. Anything in here? Nope. Let's I wanna check this out really quick, see if this works. No, okay. Well. Any other car that I can think of? Hey, there you go. Oh. Ah. Just break into enter his car. Where's the drugs? check.
Bingo. Well, Ryan, what have you been up to? It'll be very interesting to see how he explains this one.
Things are getting juicy now. A film containing a check for £500 intended for Kate was found in Ryan's car. Juicy! I believe he's an actual police inspector. Fire. Supposedly. He's an inspector.
Ask about a few more things, please.
Yeah.
Would you like to explain what this is, please, Ryan? £500 intended for Kate. It fell out of your car. At least I assume that's
fell
your
out
car
of your
on the
car.
Driveway at Brandon House.
I suppose so.
So why were you going to give Kate £500, Ryan?
It was just a little incentive, that's all. Just a little incentive.
Not very little, Ryan. £500?
She was a very good student. We heard that she was leaving. We wanted to give her something.
But you didn't.
Well, obviously not.
Are you sure there wasn't any other reason you might want to give her this? Personal reason?
No!
Well, I'd like to keep hold of this for a little while, if you don't mind.
Well, don't consider it a bribe, will you, Inspector?
See, no ulterior reason for giving Kate the money. Heard Kate wanted to leave Atlas. Oh, she never. Yeah, she said. There. Ah, no, damn it. Kate wanted to blackmail Ryan. Oh, yeah, that's right. He didn't know anything about that, though, right? Simon had been trying to undermine Kate. No, I don't have anything to do with it. I doubt it would be in the same one now. Let's go ask Emma, because she was the one who knew about the bribe, I think.
Couple more questions.
See if she has anything
that's
to say about it. Ah, well, she wouldn't know. Fuck. Okay.
Be back later on, if that's okay.
Would Paul know anything? I doubt it. We'll ask him anyway.
A few more questions, please.
What are prime candidates?
The best of the bunch. The peaches.
And so what does it mean to be a prime candidate?
Success. We have a special relationship with many major international companies. We provide them with our best students. And they get an instant job.
Happy at the course.
And what do you get out of it?
Well, it's a little kickback. It's just business, Inspector.
Now, why do you think Ryan might want to give Kate a cheque for £500?
I really have no idea now. Where did you find it?
Just outside.
Where did you find it? Better ask him.
You think Ryan was interested romantically in Kate?
I know he has a weakness for blondes, but I didn't think it had gone so far as his offering them cash.
Yeah.
Thank you. Probably.
Alright, I'll try which charges are great. Also, give me a little bit of time to try and figure it out on my own. I appreciate the help, but don't need to give me the answers right away.
I'll ask you a couple more things, please.
No, that doesn't seem to be it. Was she having any emotional problems? See, you think that would work, because she said she was leaving, so why would she leave if she was enjoying it and was happy there? This? I think I did. Didn't ask Simon about it though.
That's it for the time being. Thank you.
Ask Simon about the money. Maybe he would know. He was more involved in all of this. The more we unravel, the more we learn. He's getting deeper involved.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
You wouldn't know about the money. Fuck. Okay.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Seems like it would have to be something with Ryan then, right?
Very much so, sir. An interesting discovery in Ryan's car. A check for £500 from Ryan made out to Kate.
Blimey, how does he explain that?
He said it was an incentive. Apparently he'd heard she was thinking of leaving the course.
What made her so special that they were willing to pay her to stay?
Just a good student, I suppose.
Nah, doesn't add up. £500 is a lot more than an incentive, Jenks. You can buy questions in Parliament for that kind of money. Sounds pretty desperate. Keep on her, Ryan, about it. Oh, and get yourself another drink.
Another drink. Thanks, Chief.
I'm having one. Bye.
Right, yeah. Somehow have to connect the fucking money and... Oh, thank you for the follow, guys.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Let's look through here. Tested, never asked Simon to test Kate. Someone's been trying to undermine Kate. Poppy pods. Moxie's kids are distracted. Top. Storeroom. Simon's laptop. Arthritis. I wonder if he was buying morphine from Kate. Nah, that wouldn't make sense. Keyring. This is accusations. If something to do with them doing the... been a refund, maybe. Oh. You want to leave Atlas? No. What's your reason for giving Kate the money? Oh. Was he buying a guitar? Kate, no, Kate didn't have guitars, though. Phrase about getting rid of guilt and self-doubt. Liam's death, we're like on the cusp. I can feel it. I feel like this should be the answer. Oh, do you guys have any ideas? I feel like this should be right. Let's let him listen to this
again.
Would
you like to explain what this is, please, Ryan? £500 intended for Kate. It fell out of your car. At least I assume that's your car on the driveway at Brandon House.
I suppose so.
So why were you going to give Kate £500, Ryan?
It was just a little incentive, that's all. Just a little incentive.
Not very little, Ryan. £500.
She was a very good student. We heard that she was leaving. We wanted to give her something.
But you didn't.
Well, obviously not.
Are you sure there wasn't any other reason you might want to give her this? Personal reason?
No!
Well, I'd like to keep hold of this for a little while, if you don't mind.
Well, don't consider it a bribe, will you, Inspector?
A bribe? It said she wouldn't know anything about it, at least I think. Maybe it has something to do with, fuck, where is it? Was the affair, but we don't really know. He never really outright came and said. Ah, fuck. Psychology. Brought drugs. Yeah, Ryan never talked about the affair, so we can't use that against him. They're related. I think I tried this actually. I did. Simon, it said Simon wouldn't know about it either. Personal reasons. If we could really put that together. It's okay, we just hit another one of those walls. It'll come to us. I'm sure it will. Hmm.
guessing there's nothing. What's that? Did they say that's... Oh. I'm testing for prime strength and Simon testing Kate. No, it says never ask Simon to test Kate. Surprised the students aren't going to survive in any way. Gotcha.
Ah. So, students aren't coerced or bribed in any way, except Kate.
I'm not sure what you mean.
You said you were going to give Kate the £500 as an incentive. That's coercion, isn't it?
I really don't think you could call it coercion, Inspector. It was an incentive, that's all, a little encouragement.
So, how often do you use incentives?
Okay, incentive is probably the wrong word. The money was just to see how Kate would respond. It was part of her assessment.
Assessment?
We have to assess students as they progress. We don't use conventional methods like sitting an exam or anything like that. People pay for this course per session. We have to know if they're committed or not.
So you're assessing their progress and testing their commitment?
Yes, we are. We have to. This is a business, not a charity.
Oh shit.
So Ryan's claiming the money was part of
Oh
Kate's
god, here
assessment.
Comes Darren. Thank you for the host.
Did this assessment also involve threshold testing, I wonder? Or was the money for something else?
Here it comes, wait for it, there it is, yeah! You don't hear me say, please, oh baby, don't go simple and clean as the way that you're making me feel tonight. It's hard to let it go. Thank you for the host, Darren. Oh, you're great. Welcome everybody from Darren's stream. Hi, I'm GPM. We're in the middle of an adventure game here. A full motion video adventure game called Contradiction. Don't spot the liar. And we're pretty close to the end of the game now. The main goal is to contradict what people say, or find contradictions in what people say based on what they tell us in descriptions about shit we show them. You can't host for zero viewers, just to have that come up, sadly. There is a limit, because people started getting dumb with it. They say they didn't test students like that. Fuck, where is that at?
Aha. Well, which one is it, Ryan? Do you test students or not?
Well, some of them, yes.
Including Kate.
Yes.
Why? Yes. Tested.
She was being tested because.
Yeah.
Because we wanted to see if she was good enough to become prime candidate, okay?
So Kate was in the running to be prime candidate.
Yes!
And did you ask Simon to test her?
Yes, I did. But I didn't ask him to do anything stupid. He knew it was against course rules.
How far did you ask him to push her?
I didn't ask him to push her. I asked him to test her. There's a huge difference!
God, he's...
If Ooh. Simon decided to give her too much caffeine or morphine or whatever, that's his responsibility. So if he did anything
bam,
wrong,
bam, bam, bam,
it was his
bam,
own
bam,
responsibility.
Bam, 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 bam.
He did it with his own mind and his own hand. We had nothing to do with it.
Midnight. And still no suspect. Unless you count everyone I've interviewed. It's no surprise that Ryan wants to avoid any suggestion of being responsible for Kate's death. But I wonder if the man protests just a little too much.
Did we get anything new? Ryan gave information that Kate was in the ring to be- Oh, okay. So we actually got the information. Well, let's go all the way back down here. Go through the motions. Inspector's face was like, I got you, bitch. Let's call Chief. God, I want there to be more of Jinx. This fucking game is great. Alright, nothing from him. Okay. Yeah, the guy with the hat is British Nicolas Cage, basically. Every time he speaks, he just, like, makes these weird facial emotions. Like, he's super into it. That's a good one, Palmers.
A couple more questions, if that's okay.
Ask him about the candidate.
Was Kate a prime candidate?
Well... As Ryan has probably already told you, yes, she was.
Did you ask Simon to test her?
Yes, it's company policy. Leaders don't get involved.
And it covers your back, of course.
Well, nobody knows the students better than they do, Inspector. It's much better to let them just work it out among themselves.
It isn't very professional to force students to test each other to the point where one of them gets killed, Paul.
We don't force students to do anything that they don't want to do, Inspector.
So you don't force them into being tested?
No, we don't encourage anybody to hurt or offend anybody else here.
You don't use threshold testing, for instance?
No. If Simon Thompson went too far with Kate, that's his responsibility, not ours. He's the one you should be speaking to, if truth be told. I don't trust him myself.
God, it's starting to, like, make sense that this is gonna be more grounded and, like, how it happened is starting to come together. But, like, midway through the game, they were, like, throwing some shit about, like, cults and, like, Satan worship. I was really hoping we were gonna get some actual demons.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
And, like, go completely off the fucking wall towards the end. I was really hoping for that, but I don't think we're gonna get that. It was a real bummer. Really want that, though. That's Rebecca. Anybody in the fucking restaurant? I mean, it's like midnight. I mean, the restaurant would be closed, presumably, but... No. I guess not. Yeah, and the accusations of slavery, too. Fucking hell.
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
Do you know what a prime candidate is?
At Atlas, is the best student.
And what does that mean?
It means they get a guaranteed job with a very good salary. Well, that's the idea anyway.
But?
Mostly they aren't up to it.
What happens then?
They get sacked.
Well, they get sacked, mate.
Did you know Kate Vine was a prime candidate?
No.
Oh, yeah?
Be back later on, if that's okay.
Anything in the Edenton Village Hall yet? No, of course not. Let's check our progress. 93%. We're basically, I think this is the last hour. So we're, like, about to solve the mystery.
Ask you a couple more things, please. How do you think you'd have reacted if you'd found out that Kate had been chosen to be prime candidate?
Is that... was she?
I'm just asking how you think you'd react.
I don't know. I wouldn't react in any way, really. I'm not bothered. I don't think she was, though.
What makes you think that?
Well, it's just an impression I got. You know, she's a bit flaky, to be honest. She's just not really prime candidate material.
Okay. As another Rebecca that one's bringing shame to the name. Yeah, she's a little weird. Oh, Simon asked Ren to ask him to test Kate. Well, of course you fucking knew. Is that not it? No, okay. Oh, so he tested him, but he didn't think that she would have been actually chosen for it. Okay. I guess you can ask
okay,
Emma.
That's
well,
it
I don't think
now.
She would know
thank
much.
You. Do you know whether Kate was in the running to be prime candidate or not?
I don't, but I do think she would have been chosen. Just because she was, you know, Kate.
You didn't discuss it with Kate?
No. No, she never talked about this.
She thinks she would have been chosen. Huh.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Back to Simon.
Thank you.
Well,
we'll probably be back
I guess
later.
Let's do our daily rounds of the forest. I don't think there was a question that would involve... Because he never, like, said, oh, I was undermining Kate. Fucking weirdo to stab himself in the hand. No, damn it. Should we push on Emma? Alright, if you think so. We'll try to anyway.
Just a few more questions if you don't mind.
TK very often. Yeah, I mean. Yeah, Kate didn't really talk about, according to what she said anyway. That doesn't contradict anything she said. Not that I can think of.
That's all for the moment, thank you.
Yeah, if only we could use that, Herpy. Obviously we can't talk to Ryan. Well, you know what? It is a weird hour, quote unquote. Let's go see if the fuck is the cleaner dude is there. Just gonna keep looking. It's okay, Four. I'm glad you're here anyway. Yeah, the way this game works is you can only use what people said in the basically you can only use what they said themselves against themselves. You can't use what other people said. Anything in the sex room? I mean, it's midnight. That's when you get down and horny. Nothing? No. Okay.
Ryan gave me a bunch of keys. You rang. Obviously, I don't think I can ask him about it. Yeah, imagine an inspector coming to your house, looking at his notebook, and then just leaving without saying anything. Be back soon! Like, what? Anything change upstairs? Let me go in the mirror room. Let me trip out, take some of that dude's morphine. Nah, nothing in here. Nah, hey, you missed, pal. That's what everyone reminds me of. Of course it would be Limp Bizkit. Of course it would be, Darren. I guess we can ask the crazy fuck about it.
A few more things, please.
James definitely wanna know about the... Is he wanna know anything? Fuck, okay.
Be back later on if that's okay.
Let's check out the greenhouse, see if we can trigger anything new, maybe. Kind of going through the motions here. How's poppy seeds coming, boy? Oh, okay. Hey, spoilers, Jinx is bald under the hat. Kind of caught a glimpse of it when he got mugged. Simon or Ryan. That's what I'm thinking, Blueberry. But it's hard to believe. Well, we actually can't talk to Ryan right now. Unless we can talk to him in here.
Couple more questions, if that's okay.
No, we can't. Okay. So it has to be Simon then, right? Or would it be Paul? Don't use threshold testing. Did he say they use threshold testing? I swear, I remember. Where they said, like, before. Jennifer. Was it somebody else that said that they did threshold testing? Betting on Rebecca. I feel like it's Rebecca too. Although I don't know.
She does seem like she's very in control. Wait, they mentioned Kate was blonde? What? Wait, what? Yeah, Kate wasn't blonde. What? That's not blonde. Unless that's like just a weird, really weird picture. Also, hey AJ, how's it going? Knows Ryan was into blondes, but is she blonde? Doesn't really look blonde. Maybe she dyed her less hard of meaning around. Maybe it's just a red herring, I don't know. Yeah, it's definitely like red. Okay. Huh. Maybe she dyed her hair. This is Contradiction, Spot the Liar. It's a FMV murder mystery adventure game. What the fuck, maybe? Maybe, yeah. Maybe structural testing.
Thank you.
Let me work on Simon a little bit. Skate or die, dude. You either skate or you die. Smoke weed or die. Frankly, I think you should all die.
A few more questions, please.
Anyone know about the money? You never met Kate. It was Simon's homebrew that killed her. Oh god, what if he fucking put opium in his homebrew, gave it to Kate, and that killed... God, that'd be so fucking stupid. I mean, James did say his homebrew was killer. Knock your eyes out. God, there's just so much inventory to go through now. A little bit. God damn, this is a tough wall here.
That's it for the time being, thank you.
Are we not allowed to hurt others? Gave Kate drugs?
I'll ask you a couple more things, please.
Where's that at? Is that on the Alice flyer?
see. Guitar. Oh. No. Offend others. Damn. This is a real wall. Did we already call the chief?
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Trying to call him anyway? Let's try that. I think we're missing a trigger somewhere or something. It can get us to talk to James again. Oh, here we go.
Hello, Jenks. Yes, I'm still up. Thanks for asking.
Chief Ryan admitted that he asked Simon to test Kate to see if she was good enough to be prime candidate. But he's throwing it all back on Simon. Says it was up to Simon about how he went about testing her.
Very convenient. What does Paul say?
He pretty much backs Ryan up. He claims they don't do any threshold testing.
Well, that's a load of horse droppings. He knows you're onto him, Jenks, which means you're getting somewhere at last. It's only taking you until midnight, but well done nonetheless. Listen, call me back. I'm watching an old movie, but Christopher Lee's only just turned up, so I'll be here for another hour or so, yeah?
Okay, aww. Chief, I'll call again.
Yeah, bye.
Rest in peace, Christopher Lee. Alright. So we gotta pressure Paul.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
See, that's what I thought. He said he doesn't use threshold testing, but I swear to God. They did something here. All is pretty hard to infiltrate. Yes, he says, didn't expect Emma to discuss. Says he didn't encourage. I can't just use the money stunt, because I thought that would have been like a threshold thing. Oh, here we go. This is it. No? The DVD. Fuck. That's totally a threshold thing. Yeah, the CD mentioned something about- Oh. I'm sorry. I didn't. Gotcha.
You say you don't endorse threshold testing, that's the phrase, isn't it?
Yes.
Except you do, Paul. Because you told me that the students use that CD in the mirror room. I've listened to that CD, and it very clearly mentions threshold testing. You keep batting this away, Paul. We don't really use hypnosis. The students aren't really tested. But I am this close to launching a full-scale investigation.
Look, we get a kickback from these students, and they have to be exceptional. Of course we have to test them. That doesn't mean we do anything illegal. What do you think we do? Bump off the ones we don't like?
Well, that depends on how far you push them, doesn't it?
Well, we certainly don't kill them. Nobody here wanted Kate dead.
I'm sure they didn't. But what do you expect, Paul, when you put students under that much pressure?
She was a very, very valuable student. She was worth a lot to the business.
Really? And how much would that be?
Well, if you really want to know, 50 grand.
Ooh.
She was worth 50 grand?
Yes.
What, you were selling her?
Of course we were selling her. You don't get this, do you?
Oh.
We make perfect employees. Month after month, that's all we do.
What do you mean, perfect employees?
What big business needs, Inspector, more than anything else, is none of this altruistic, goody-goody crap. What we look for is people with ambition,
oh.
No ethics, push, greed is good, all right? We don't deal with all this comfort stuff. The survival of the fittest, that's all there is. There's no higher purpose, no big plan. There's nothing at the end of the rainbow, except what you have and you can enjoy in the here and now.
And what do you enjoy now, Paul?
You're gonna have to excuse me, Inspector. I'm a very busy man. I've got work to do.
I'll see myself out.
So what I think, like, oh, hey.
Lovely man, your father.
Shut the gate on your way out.
Doing his level best to shut this place down. Get rid of him. He's a policeman. We can't just. You saw this, Ryan. You man up and you sort it tonight.
Kyle. Fucking dead. Kyle. Kyle.
That doesn't sound good. Two totally morally bankrupt men are plotting to get rid of me. It's midnight. I don't have any backup and I don't even have a mobile phone. This is potentially quite bad. What's Kyle got to do with it? I think I might make my way over to Atlas while Ryan isn't there. Maybe lock myself in.
Is Kyle gonna fucking shank us? Damn.
Damn. I suppose it was too much to hope that Ryan had left the place open.
Do I have any keys? Screwdriver. Nah, of course not. All right, well, shit. I guess we're gonna die. Let's. Oh, hey, James. Oh fuck! What? What?
Prove to me that you're man enough to do this, Kyle, and then you can deal with that ridiculous police inspector.
What? Holy shit.
What is this? What the hell? Scotland Yard. Not hell. Hello, Ryan.
Hello, Inspector. What are you doing here?
Inspecting? So, come on. Let's have it.
I don't think you'd understand, Inspector. The best thing that you can do is turn around, go away, and leave us to it.
Knife.
What?
That knife gives me a perfect right to stick my nose in, investigate, and interfere.
This is all part of the Atlas course. It's a physical endurance exercise.
Drop the knife. The knife, Kyle!
Kyle.
Drop it! Not looking 100% brilliant for you, Ryan.
Well, please, Inspector, you've poked your nose into Atlas's affairs enough times to know that imaginative flair is part of the course's success.
Our lessons are reinforced by a unique emotional experience.
Terror?
It's an extremely evocative tool.
Well, it's a good job you're not in charge of the national curriculum.
Now look, Inspector, I know what you're trying to do. I know what you're thinking. But believe me, Atlas had nothing to do with the deaths of those people.
Eyewitness account of a satanic sacrifice in the woods. That's not what we call circumstantial evidence, Ryan.
Simon. Now, I saw Simon walking home with Kate last Friday after the meeting. Now, Simon had some strange idea that he was in the running to become prime candidate. Well, a knob of butter has more chance of becoming prime minister. Oh, wait.
So are you telling me that...
Simon killed her? Well, that seems reasonable. It's likely, isn't it?
Gee.
Any more likely than you, Ryan. Pig!
Holy shit!
Police brutality.
What?
It's alright. Are you okay?
Good. Bye, girl. That was... certainly was something, I guess. I mean, saying if you're mad enough to do this, you're mad enough to do this to the inspector. You know... oh, hold on, I gotta go... yeah, I didn't check down here. Actually, was that Emma? That wasn't Emma.
A few more questions, if you don't mind. What would you say if I said it's been suggested that you were seen walking home with Kate after Atlas last Friday?
What? By who?
The same person who suggested that you wanted Kate out of the picture because you found out she was in the running to be prime candidate.
Who said that?
Just a question.
I didn't think I was in the running. It was Ryan, wasn't it?
I am in no position to say.
It was Ryan!
Simon, calm down.
No, I can prove it. Kate's driving license, give it to me.
Why?
Kate's driving license, please. See that pattern on the tape there? Let me show you something. See this pattern? Now look at that. It's the same pattern. This has come from the same roll of tape as this.
So
there's only one person that's taped like that. Ryan. He gave me this piece of tape when I was in his office once. Why has Kate's driving license got a piece of Ryan's tape on it?
He said he's never seen the license, though.
Where did you find it?
Oh, by the lake.
That's obvious, isn't it? Ryan was testing her. He was doing a boundary test to see how much she would do, how far she would go to be a prime candidate. But it all went wrong. Okay. It's one of the things we do at the course. Right? You give something that's important to you to someone else. Then they go and hide it somewhere. It's to teach you to not be bothered when you lose something that's important to you, alright? Kate gives her driving license to Ryan. Ryan goes and hides it somewhere down the lake. Kate finds out, she goes down looking for it, probably drunk, and she falls in.
I'm afraid I find that a bit far-fetched, Simon.
It makes perfect sense if you know anything at all about how Atlas works.
But Simon, if you got the tape from Ryan, Kate could have got it from him.
He told me he doesn't lend it out.
He lent it to you.
But I didn't kill her! Do a lab test on the card! His DNA will be all over it.
And what if yours is all over it?
It won't be! I didn't kill her! I'm sorry, just give me a minute. I need some painkillers.
What?
Is he gonna fucking split? He fucking ran away. God damn.
Where did he go in such a hurry? Is he trying to act as suspiciously as possible?
We're gonna have to track him down now. Oop, wrong way. Damn, no. Fuck, he's fucking gone. Shit, okay. I wonder if he ran off to Edenton. Can we go there finally? Is this gonna... Fuck! Never! Of course not. I wonder if he booked it behind the pub. We're never gonna fucking... have any use for the village hall anymore. I guess we could talk to Ryan, see if, or talk to Emma, see if she knows anything at all. Maybe he did go after Ryan, yeah.
That's okay.
We'll get to there.
Did Simon mention walking home with anyone after the meeting last Friday?
No, he just came home. Why?
He didn't mention walking home with Kate.
No, definitely not.
Have you seen this anywhere before?
I've seen it somewhere, but can't remember. Sorry, no.
Alright. And she wouldn't know anything about that. Okay.
That's all for the moment.
The pills in the pub! Good point. We're gonna have a fist fight in the fucking diner? Damn! Of course not.
A few more questions, please. Thank you. Have you seen patterned tape like this anywhere before?
Oh, Ryan's got some. I know, because I borrowed it.
When was that?
A couple of months ago.
Have you still got it?
I don't think so. I haven't seen it since then.
See, last little tape from 2 months ago. And some parents. Okay, so it's Ryan's. On, if that's for sure. Okay. Can we go fuck in their house? No, I guess not. Oh, looks like it just rained. Anything new back down here? Nope. Lakey Philly Pomo. Got your new gun?
Ask you a couple more things, please. Do you know how well Simon knew Kate?
Not really.
Did you ever see them together?
So why? Do you think he killed her?
I've no idea. Do you think he'd be capable of that?
Don't you think we're all capable of it?
Yeah, man.
Sure. So you've never been in your police car responding to an incident, driven past a school at high speed?
Dunno. Maybe.
Well, you've answered your own question, then.
When you've got a need and things get in your way, it's human nature to either ignore them or get rid of them. Any way you can. That's all murder is, isn't it?
Maybe you're right. Ever seen tape like this anywhere before?
No.
No.
Okay, that's it for now. Thank you.
I wouldn't know what you're talking about. Did he go in his greenhouse and steal those opiate pods, perhaps? I doubt it. What the fuck did he run off to, though? Yeah, every fucking recording, he's always just staring off into space, so I'm just assuming he's consistently blazed out of his goddamn mind. I couldn't check the pill cabinet. Didn't give me an option to. I've exhausted all my options now. I can talk to the chief. Oh God.
Paul admitted that they do use threshold testing. Apparently they get a wedge of cash from various companies in exchange for each prime candidate they produce.
Interesting.
Also, I met Ryan and some of his friends in the woods in the middle of some sort of occult ceremony. I have no idea what they were doing, but it did not look good. But Ryan insisted that Simon walked Kate home after the meeting last Friday. He's claiming Simon killed her.
And what does Simon say?
He doesn't agree, not surprisingly. He says it was Ryan, because of something to do with a piece of tape stuck to Kate's driving license, which Simon claims belonged to Ryan. Claims it was Ryan who was testing Kate by sticking the driving license to a tree in the woods in the dark and telling Kate to get it, knowing she'd fall in. And no, before you ask, it doesn't make any sense to me either.
Right, so basically Simon says Ryan was testing her and Ryan says Simon was testing her. Well, either one of them is lying or neither of them are. And nobody who is testing anybody.
I suppose that's always a possibility.
Wouldn't surprise me, Jenks. Well, I don't know. Can I help you?
God damn it.
Just check everything that everyone said. Go through everyone's statements. The answer's in there somewhere. Call me back when there's some good news, eh? Preferably a confession.
Well, if I can get one.
Yeah.
Thanks, Chief.
Good night.
So we just have to fucking... Okay. Is the tape on the window? Chief, you're plotting my murder. You really should probably send somebody for backup. Maybe, please. Might be a good idea to save the game, you're right. Put in both slots. I have a thing.
More questions, if you don't mind. Thank you. Probably be back later.
I feel like that tape is, like, super important right now. Whether or not they said they saw it, or...
I don't think anybody said they knew, like, she lost her license. Is this Emma, maybe? I mean, our options are limited between Emma, Rebecca, and James. I don't think we can talk to anybody else right now.
Ask about a few more things, please.
Sorry, Jenks, you're expendable. Ah, damn it. If Jinx is the murderer, I'm gonna fucking... shit.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
I mean, I don't think, like, what kind of tape they used was a thing, but... I think you would be able to go back and check what kind of tape it was, but I'll entertain it, sure. What tape was used on the window?
Couple more questions, if that's okay?
I'll take a look here. Oh, fuck, where's that at? All the way back here. Your pub window? Oh, shit, I was right. Or you guys said
you last saw that sticky tape 2 months ago. Is that correct?
Yes.
So how come you used it last week to tape over the broken window outside? That's the same tape.
Well, I must have been mistaken.
You see, the reason I'm asking is that it's exactly the same tape that was found attached to Kate's driving license, found at the scene. The tape that only Ryan has. Ryan, and of course, you.
So what are you saying?
Who's got the tape now? Do you know where it is?
No. No, I don't know where it is. Why are you asking me about this tape?
You seem nervous, Rebecca. Is there a problem?
Well, you're practically accusing me of having something to do with that woman's murder, aren't you?
I wasn't accusing you of anything, Rebecca. Unless there's something you'd like to tell me.
No, I wouldn't like to tell you anything.
Okay, well, that's fine. Obviously, we'll be swabbing everyone in the area for DNA, so if anything comes up on Kate's license, DNA traces.
What'll come up? Nothing'll come up. Right, I've had enough. I've got to get back.
Rebecca! Would you like to explain to me exactly what is going on?
Which bit? The fact that some leggy bitch was trying to steal my husband?
Oh, here he goes.
I think you had better tell me what you know, Rebecca.
Okay. You want to know what I know? Kate Vine seduced my husband and was going to blackmail him. Not only did she sleep with him, that whore did it just for his money. Our money.
How did you work that out?
I heard her. I knew it was her arguing with Emma Bowman. Emma was trying to talk her out of it.
And how did she come to be at the lake?
She dropped that driving license thing when she came in. She was drunk. She dropped her bag. I took it out to the woods and stuck it over the lake. Then I waited for her. When she came out, I told her where it was, that someone had just run off into the woods with it.
You led her to the lake.
She was reaching out over the lake to get it. I didn't do anything. She just fell in.
But you let her drown.
It was dark. I couldn't see anything.
Man, I was really hoping for demons.
Really? Did you try, Rebecca?
Well, it was too late. She was just flapping about in the water. It was pathetic. She was making these gurgling sounds.
And what did you do?
I got a big stick. I just pushed her down with it until she stopped.
What?
Well, she was dead anyway. What did it
I
matter?
I just got a big stick and pushed her down in it.
Rebecca.
But she slept with my husband.
She didn't, Rebecca.
What do you mean?
You got the wrong girl.
Who? Emma. It was Emma.
It was Rebecca all Rand, for nothing.
I am arresting you for the murder of Kate Vine.
Get fucked.
Don't say anything, but anything you do say may be taken down and will be used in evidence against you. Do you understand?
Yes.
So, it appears that Kate Vine's death was a tragic case of mistaken identity. But there are some loose threads here. What was Ryan doing with Kyle and that girl in the woods?
Or is this sequel bait? Interrupted.
And what really happened to Liam last year? It seems I've only scratched the surface of Atlas and the Rand business empire. Trying to find out about Paul Rand's past is like peering into dense fog. He gives nothing away and covers his tracks with military efficiency. However, what is known is that Paul Rand has a lot of connections in high places. Politicians, celebrities, business leaders. Perhaps James Wilson's ideas weren't too wide of the mark after all. I get the feeling there's still a lot more to learn about the Rand business empire.
You're gonna have to excuse us. Atlas is closed for the moment, but we'll be open again very soon. Thank you for your interest.
Oh. Wow. That was pretty fucking cool. Inspector Jinx, Rupert Booth. Wow. Simon was Magnus Sin. Wow. That was pretty fucking cool. That was definitely awesome. I really want to see more Contradiction. I want to see more of fucking Jinx. Filmed in Great Bridges, Chester, and St. Helens Land, UK. This was a Kickstarter game? Wow. I didn't know that. Well, fuck. Shit, if there's gonna be a Kickstarter for a sequel, I'm gonna fucking fund the shit out of that. God, that was fucking cool. Oh, what? Okay. Actors just fucking around. Dedicated to Paul Darrow. Oh, that does sound familiar. This is an experimental independent game. I attach it with light like from the game. So, support is vital if you raise funding for a sequel. Oh man, you guys should fucking support the hell out of this game. God, that was so good. I could not recommend this game any more than I already. Oh. I just hit escape and... Oh, it just brings you back to your last save. Okay. We didn't use any cheats. I'm the greatest. That was pretty fucking incredible. So this game is out on Steam. Let me bring up a thing here. This is $10 on Steam right now. I think the cheats just probably maybe tell you exactly what to do, I would imagine. Yeah, this game is incredible. Alright, I'm gonna take a quick BRB, and we're gonna switch over to playing some Bayonetta. Stick around, stay tuned, and I will be right back.